Greetings. Welcome to Learner Burn Studios. My name's Eric Stevenson. And in today's video, I'm going to teach you how I make my ideal pouring cup. Starting off with a styrofoam cup, about a 16 ounce, and with a few coats of wax and some cardboard, I want to talk to you about why I make my cups this way and how I go about that. So with that said, let's get started. There's a variety of ways you can do this. I start off with styrofoam cups and dip them in wax, do in several coats. So it's currently my wax temperature is about 200 degrees. If I start off with 250, which is what, you know, we started off with when we were doing the slush casting, it wouldn't quite melt the styrofoam, but it will take way too many coats and way too much time to actually dip the cups. So at 200 degrees, I can get a decent coat to them. It'll cool off quick enough. And instead of just doing one or two cups, I'm gonna go through and do a whole sleeve of them, which is 20 cups. So we're gonna do, so with one coat covered, you still see the color of the cup. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do two, maybe three more coats until this is, you know, a little bit more opaque. And then we're gonna fill in and pour buttons, basically kind of fill up this upper ridge. One thing about these cups, or most cups in general, there's a bit of a lip across the bottom. But this gives us an opportunity to build up the wax, which will give us a nice surface and a nice thickness of wax to be able to weld our gates to. So, on to the second coat. Okay, so as much as it looked a little on the thin side after two coats, I thought I'd do three coats, but now that it's cool, the wax has become a little more opaque, and so I think I will go ahead and do my buttons next. And again, the wax is still about 200 degrees. What I'm gonna do is just pour these. And what I'm trying to do is be mindful of the surface tension and try not to have it roll off the edges. That allows me to make them just a touch thicker. Okay, so actually while we're waiting for the buttons to solidify, another task can be done while you're waiting for things to cool down is that we want to cut off a series of square cardboard sections. Typically, what I like to do is have them so they're just maybe about an eighth inch bigger than the top of my cup, and this will allow me to be able to grip a hold of it. One, small enough that I can get my hand around it so I can hold on to it while I'm in the dipping process. But we will also have a couple of boards that will be a little bit larger in size. The purpose of the cardboard is a couple different things. One, it seals off the cup, so as this is floating around in the slurry, the ceramic shell, the cup's not filling up with slurry and we're not casting the inside of the cup. Also, the way we're going to sprue these is that we're actually going to gate things in such a way that everything balances on top of the cup, so it can dry evenly around the sprue system. And so by creating the cardboard sections, it'll give me a nice flat surface for these things to balance on. And so that's part of the reason why I'll go in and use a couple of different sizes of cardboard. So if I have some sprue systems that are a little bit larger and need a little bit bigger footprint to rest on, that gives me that ability in using a couple of different sizes. Although probably 90% of the cardboard I'll use will be just about the size of the cup. And so then what I like to do is I want to just, you know, get a thin coat of wax on these so they're a little bit easier to weld to the cups themselves. So I'll just go through, dip them about two-thirds of the way, shake them off a little bit, and we'll set these things off to the side, wherever you might have room. And the reason why I don't stick them all the way in is that I don't want to get wax all over my fingers. So I'll dip them, you know, two-thirds of the way in, And then when they once they cool down enough, then I'll go in and dip the other sides. We'll go ahead and dip the other half, or in this case, the other third. And again, we can, ultimately there's a variety of ways you can do your pour cups. You can start off with a plaster or a rubber mold of a cup and actually make wax cups. Some people will use paper cups and then dip them in wax. The reason I prefer the styrofoam is that it burns out a lot faster. What I want to do, be able to do is, as we're, when we stick our investments into the burnout kiln to burn the wax and evacuate the wax out of the investment, I want, you know, it's all dependent on how quickly the cup can evacuate before the gate system can evacuate and then ultimately the pattern. And as the wax is heating up, it's actually expanding and can potentially crack your shell. So the faster we can get the wax out of the investment, the better. The styrofoam cups have the ability to vaporize very quickly and stuff. Now that the cardboards are dipped, we'll go back to our cups. We're gonna do two more coats. Seal in the buttons. I don't want to go too quickly. I want to get a nice even coat. I'm trying to let off as much drip off as possible, because I don't want these things just to be covered in drips. I want the ultimate my cup to be as smooth as possible, so when the metal hits it, it's not creating any additional turbulence that might draw in unneeded air as the metal flows into the gating system. And so now we'll do the second coat. I'm actually gonna do a third coat, real dip. And then center it on the cup. So two. Try to get it somewhat centered. Slice back up to the front. And these things have solidified enough that now I can go in and again do two more dips. To fully seal and weld the cardboard to the cups. Okay, so there we go. I guess a series of two dips a button, two dips on the bottom, two dips on the top, seal the lid, two more seal coats, and now we have our wax cups. Like I said, try to be as clean about it as possible with the least amount of drips, but inherently, you know, you do get a few drips. If you catch them while things are still warm enough, you can flatten them out while the wax is still soft. But that will give us a nice foundation to base the rest of our gating system on, the rest of our sprue system. So there you go. We have our pour cups ready to go, ready for our patterns. And so if you found this helpful, please hit the like button. If you'd like to continue seeing different aspects of my process, and specifically with lost wax casting, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. And until then, be creative and be safe.